Hi there, this is Ranjit, and in this video of Weekly Talks, I'm going to talk about next biggest innovation I feel that is going to be there with smartphones. And by the way, I'm recording this video with the Nexus 6P's front-facing camera, and I don't think so it's handling the exposure very well. So let me go to a little bit shadowed area and then we'll continue. So this is much better. And to give you an idea, I feel this innovation, whenever it comes, might not just benefit smartphone, but the entire technology industries, and will change how we use our devices. But first, let's talk about smartphones and why I feel smartphones are so important and one of the most revolutionary, what do you say, tech piece of technology that we have seen in the last couple of decades. Let me talk a little bit about history. I have been starting playing with computers when I was just 10 or 11 years old, and now I'm about 38. So it's over 25 years since I've been using computers. When we had those computers when I was 10 or 11, used to be really bulky. It had that proper monochrome screen. It had the green letter CRT, huge box. So now when I see the modern smartphones, is nothing but science fiction. The amount of power these modern smartphones have and the kind of stuff that they can do is just bonkers in my opinion. To just give you an idea, the processors on these smartphones have evolved so much, and I feel the most of the tech innovations these days are happening on the smartphone front. And that makes sense, because smartphone is one of those rare devices that you carry with you all the time. And if you think of it, it's like your pocket computer that you carry with you. You do a lot of tasks actually with your smartphone that you don't even realize. Let's go over them first. First, let's talk about the processors. We have seen a huge evolution in terms of the processors of the smartphone. We had the single core processors a couple of years ago. Then we had the dual core. Now we have the quad core and even the octa core. It simply does not make sense for octa core, deca core, I feel. Because I still feel many of the tasks are single threaded. Hence, you see the Apple, iPhones, they generally have a dual core processor and they perform very well, because still most of the computing tasks cannot be divided except for video work and stuff. So it's just meaningless. I would say it's better to have a powerful quad core processor than an octa core or a deca core processor, in my frank opinion. Next, if we move to one huge improvement that we are seeing now with the smartphones, is in terms of camera. The camera performance has become amazing, I would say. And if you take a good smartphone now, a flagship for example, this year we are seeing a lot of good smartphones with amazing camera performance. For example, the Samsung Galaxy S7, and it can easily replace a point and shoot camera. I feel it simply does not make any sense to carry a point and shoot camera. Yeah, they can improve still, I would say, and they are improving. And also, I've seen that the video that these smartphones can take is amazing. In fact, as you can see, I'm recording this video with the Nexus 6P, and that's with the front-facing camera. I'm not even recording it with the rear-facing camera. So the camera performance has been improving quite a bit, and now I feel the camera performance has become good enough. Even in mid-range devices, the camera is good enough, barring low-light performance, I feel. So that's a huge improvement that we are seeing. Now, if we talk about the displays, the smartphones are the pinnacles of displays. We started seeing 1080p displays a couple of years ago, and now it's not uncommon to see Quad HD displays and even 4K. 4K is gimmick for such a small screen, but yeah, again, the screen qualities have become amazing. And these days, if you buy even a mid-range device, I feel the screen quality is actually really good. Just compare the screen quality that you're getting on your laptop or your computer. The screen quality on your smartphone is way, way better. So again, innovations, what we see in smartphones, generally helps the entire industry. Later on, they go to the other industries, I feel. So this displays are also really good. Again, I made some pointers. I was thinking about this topic for the last couple of days, so this is my surface. I just took some points over there. Regarding the audio, again, that is also being taken care of now. Some specialized smartphones do pay a lot of attention to audio, and they have dedicated DACs. For example, the Vibe X3, the HTC 10, they have very good dedicated DACs. So if you are a music lover, then those things are also covered. I would see, these are sort of niche devices as of now, dedicated DACs and stuff. But in the future, we'll see that on most other smartphones also, in my frank opinion. Now, again, one more thing that we have seen this year, it started from past 1.5 years, is biometrics. We have fingerprint scanner, which we actually take for granted. And we also have, eye scan. For example, we saw that on the Lumia 950 XL and the 950. So those things are also there. So we have biometric, authentication also on our smartphones. So another improvement that I've seen last year, and this is a major improvement, I feel, was in terms of the screen shutterness. If you had a look at the Moto X4s, I feel that's again an innovation. If you drop the phone also, the screen does not shatter. So again, that's a huge improvement, I would say, in terms of usability. If you are a person who constantly drops a phone, then you have that technology now. And I think so, this technology will come in future smartphones also. We also have digital pen on our phone, so you can write it. A classic example is the Samsung Galaxy Note lineup. And again, I feel the smartphones have sort of become the primary computing device, at least for me. I check my emails and stuff first on my smartphone. For example, for news and stuff also, the first I get the alerts, etc. on my smartphone. I check my Twitter and stuff again on my smartphone. And I feel, at least for me, and I think so you might also agree, smartphone has sort of become my primary device which I carry with me. It's my primary computing device. And the biggest advantage that we have with the smartphone is that we have that computing device almost always with us. But one biggest thing that is still a limitation of smartphones, and I feel modern technology and gadgets and gizmos, is the battery life. Still the battery life, I feel, on these smartphones and other devices like laptops and etc. is simply not that great. And I feel here the pace of technology and innovation has simply not kept up. For example, yes, the battery lives have started increasing a lot compared to older phones, but that's not due to improvements in the battery technology. It's just that Qualcomm, Intel, etc. are making just better processors that consume a lot less power. The displays also are getting they are improving and they consume a lot less power. So that's why we are seeing some improvements in the battery life, but the actual battery technology has simply not evolved that much. And I feel that is one of the biggest innovations that can happen to this industry. Just imagine, currently, even if you take a very good smartphone with amazing battery life, the max you might get is about 1.5 days to max of about 2 days. Just imagine if you had a smartphone that you had to charge just once for 10 days. Just imagine the situation then. Then you have to be careful. You don't have to worry about the battery life. You can use your phone as you like. The anxiety of checking the battery, how much battery life is left, is gone. So I feel that's a huge thing that the industry has to actually look at. And I feel the battery technology, that is going to happen. It's not like we don't have technology. There are about half a dozen emerging technologies with batteries that can solve the issues. For example, scientists have shown that they can charge a smartphone with a little bit modification in the chemistry of the battery in just 15 minutes. There are again fuel cells. I don't like the concept of fuel cells because with the fuel cell, theoretically a smartphone can be powered for about 10 days. You just take out that cartridge, put in a new fuel cell, and you are up to go. But again, it's like a cartridge that you have to keep on filling. So I'm not we might see fuel cells in the upcoming transition, but I feel the battery technology has to really, really improve. And I feel only the smartphone industry can do that, because a lot of money is being poured into smartphone research. And I just hope that the big companies, etc., pay a lot more attention on the battery technology. Yes, as I've mentioned already, there are a lot of emerging technologies with the batteries that are on labs. Theoretically, they work. But again, it will take time for those technologies to come in the real world. And when that happens, it's going to change the entire industry, guys. It's not just the smartphones. Because imagine the same technology, if it's used on your laptop will have 7 or 8 days of battery life. And that changes how you use your devices. sorry that got cut, but as I was mentioning, it's not just the smartphone and the computing industry that will benefit from the improvements in battery life and new battery technology, but it's going to change almost everything, in my frank opinion. For example, just a few weeks ago, if you follow me on Twitter at Geeky Ranjit, I was tweeting that I was really interested in looking at a solar plant, putting up a mini solar plant, so that I don't have to rely on power that we get from the government and stuff, because I'm very, you guys might not know, very particular about environment, environmental friendly stuff and whatever. And I was doing a lot of research. Yeah, solar panel is not the biggest cost when you put a mini solar plant. It's a one-time cost, but the recurring cost that you have is actually the batteries. You need those batteries to store that energy so that you can use it at night and stuff. And batteries, as of now, we have those big car batteries or the lorry batteries that we use, deep discharge batteries, pretty good. But the thing is that they're not that efficient, and you have to replace them every 4 or 5 years. So if you are planning to put a solar plant, the batteries might be a recurring cost, and that makes the cost of the plant really, really high. And it's not that it's a one-time cost, it's a recurring cost. So again, if we see huge improvements in terms of battery innovation, it is not only just going to change how we use our smartphones and the laptops and stuff, but it's going to improve the entire industry. And the way we use technology and the way we live might actually change due to battery technology. So what do you think about this? Do you think battery technology is really important and we need some innovations now? Or do you disagree with me? And if you think you have an idea about what is the next biggest thing that we might see in smartphones, do share your opinion in the YouTube show notes. Again, guys, I do this weekly talks every week on Sunday. So if you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel, hit that subscribe button. Again, thanks for watching this video. This is Ranjit, and I hope to see you again in my next video.